markers changes in patients with lupus nephritis and their correlation with disease activity and tuberculation. This work was done by Walay Arafa Keshk, Naima Ali Suleiman, and Noha Oshiba. Collaboration between medical biochemistry and internal medicine department. Systemic lupus erythematosus, multi-system autoimmune disease with high morbidity and mortality, characterized by inflammation and abnormal immune system response with failure of the immune regulatory mechanism, and the kidney is one of the most commonly affected organ. Lupus characterized by increased oxidative stress, which contribute to the pathogenesis of chronic kidney disease associated with systemic lupus erythematosus. We measure advanced oxidation protein product as a marker for protein oxidation. It is derived from oxidation of albumin and fibrinogen or lipoproteins. Advanced oxidation protein product have a role in induction of macrophages activation and apoptosis. Also, patients with systemic lupus demonstrate defective clearance of the apoptotic cell with deposition of the immune complex that can stimulate beta and T cell, causing tissue damage. So we study in FE-CABA, nuclear factor CABA-B. It's a heterodimeric complex composed of two subunits, which is the key transcription factors involved in the regulation of immune response and apoptosis. Calcinosis is a soft tissue calcification associated with systemic lupus morbidity and mortality, so we study FET1A. FET1A is a glycoprotein synthesized by the liver. It is generally recognized as a calcification inhibitor factor. Vitamin D is one of the sterols that have a critical role in calcium phosphorus metabolism. Vitamin D deficiency had a role in development of neoplasm, cardiovascular disease, and increased susceptibility to infectious and autoimmune disease. And it is an immune modulatory hormone has an inhibitory effect on T and B lymphocyte and dendritic cell. The aim of this current work was to evaluate the relationship between advanced oxidation protein product as a protein oxidation biomarker, nuclear factor CABA-B, FET1A, and the 25-hydroxyvitamin D level, as well as calculated calcification risk index in lupus nephritis to evaluate their possible clinical significance in disease activity and progression. This study was carried on 45 premenopausal females. They were divided into three groups. One, group one, which represents the control group, and group two represents the systemic lupus disease patient without nephritis, and group three represents systemic lupus disease patient but with nephritis, lupus nephritis group. All patients were selected from the inpatient and outpatient clinic of internal medicine department, Tanta University Hospital. They are classified according to the American College of Rheumatology and revised criteria for diagnosis of systemic lupus. Systemic lupus disease activity index score for renal disease was range from 0 to maximum of 16. The score of more than 4 was taken as an indicator of active lupus nephritis. The individual in this study were subjected to the full hysterotaking, thorough clinical examination, routine laboratory investigation, the form of urine analysis, which is very important for to classify lupus nephritis. CBC, ACR, and fasting blood sugar, C-reactive protein, and the anti-nuclear antibody and the double-strand antibody, and the renal biopsy for diagnosis of lupus nephritis. Biochemical assessment to include an estimation of the plasma advanced oxidation protein level, estimation of peripheral mononuclear cell nuclear factor CABA-B level, serum FET1A level, serum 25-hydroxyvitamin D level, and serum calcium and organic phosphate level to calculate the calcification risk index, which is calcium by phosphorus divided by FET1A. The result of the present study showed that there is an increase in the level of serum creatinine, urinary 24 urinary albumin level, ACR, C-reactive protein ANA, and double-stranded DNA, when systemic lupus disease activity index. Lupus patients with higher level were observed for lupus nephritis group, represented here by group 3. This table shows the comparative statistics of different studied biochemical parameter. It shows that there is a significant increase in the level of plasma advanced oxidation protein product, NF-kappa-B level, serum phosphate, and the calcification risk index. However, decrease in fetuin A and the level of vitamin D in lupus nephrite lupus group with a maximum significant increase in advanced oxidation nuclear factor kappa-B. Phosphate and the calcification risk index was in lupus nephritis group. This table shows the correlation study between the studied parameters, the nuclear factor kappa-B, advanced oxidation protein product, calcification risk index, vitamin D serum fetuin A level in relation to the kidney function test and the ANA and double-stranded DNA and the systemic lupus disease activity index. There were a positive correlation as regard to nuclear factor kappa-B, advanced oxidation and the calcification risk index. However, negative correlation with kidney function was found with vitamin D level and serum fetuin A level. As systemic lupus is characterized by defective clearance of the apoptotic cell with the release of nuclear cytoplasmic autoantigen followed by chronic inflammation, autoantibody production, and affecting many organs. The main target organ is the kidney is one of the target organs affected by lupus, leading to lupus nephritis. With excessive generation of ROS generation causing lipid protein DNA damage, with generation of autoantigen, which can elicit autoimmune response by stimulating T and B lymphocyte. The increased advanced oxidation protein product in this study can be explained on the basis of inflammation and oxidative stress associated with systemic lupus, and also systemic lupus was associated with excessive infiltration of inflammatory cell as neutrophil, and neutrophil is rich in myeloperoxidase enzyme, which is responsible for production of the chlorinated oxidant, which is the main cause of formation of advanced oxidation protein product. Advanced oxidation protein product has an important role in macrophage activation and apoptosis. Inflammatory cytokine and the excessive oxidative stress that present in patients with systemic lupus also can activate nuclear factor kappa-B, which when upon its activation, it translocates to the nucleus to be activate genes responsible for inflammation, apoptosis, cell death, angiogenesis, and so lead to renal fibrosis, impairment of the renal function. So in this study, we found increased level of nuclear factor kappa-B in lupus group, with higher level for lupus nephritis patient group. Systemic lupus also associated with inflammation, and this inflammation revealed an alkaline media. This alkaline media caused calcium precipitation, leading to calcinosis or soft tissue calcification. So we study fetuin A, which is involved in the regulation of calcified matrix metabolism and an important calcification inhibitor. In this study, we found that decreased fetuin A level in patients and control with lower level were for lupus nephritis patient group. This can be explained on the basis of inflammation, which caused down regulation of fetuin A gene expression and also the significant loss of fetuin A that occurred due to excessive proteinuria, which is associated with lupus nephritis patient. Also, vitamin D is an essential hormone for bone mineral metabolism, regulates the growth and differentiation of multiple cell type, and has an immune regulatory anti-inflammatory properties through inhibition of T lymphocyte proliferation, dendritic cell differentiation, cytokine production, beta cell lymphocyte antibody, autoantibody production, and secretion. In this study, we found that the level of vitamin D in patient decreased than the control, with lowest level were found in lupus nephritis patient. This can be explained on the basis of photosensitivity and associated with systemic lupus patient, and renal involvement with defective hydroxylation and activation of vitamin D. Also, hydroxychloroquine treatments that used in treatment of systemic lupus erythematosus disease. Correlation study revealed that the decrease in the serum level of fetuin A, 25 hydroxy vitamin D, and the increased level of nuclear factor kappa-B, plasma advanced oxidation protein product, as well as calcification risk index, are related to systemic lupus disease activity and the progression, as these parameters were related to the kidney function. Conclusion: excessive production of ROS disturb redox states and can modulate the expression of inflammatory chemokines through nuclear factor kappa B, leading to inflammatory process and tissue damage, which moves more profound in lupus nephritis and could reflect disease activity. Considering antioxidant as a novel therapeutic strategy are important in systemic lupus patient and patient with lupus nephritis. Decrease the fetal AN25 hydroxy vitamin D level with abnormality in calcium phosphate metabolism are associated with disease activity and lupus nephritis. Routine screening for 25 hydroxy vitamin D deficiency and the spirometry treatment in patients with systemic lupus is recommended. Also, correlation study between the study parameter and the kidney function can reflect the role as a novel disease activity monitoring biomarker. Thank you.